Cleveland fans with an all-important matchup because on the line, control of this great company. On the line, a couple of hairdos. One, Ric Flair's, and the other one, Eric Bischoff. And David Flair, only his second wrestling match, his first singles match. But we brought up last night that Ric Flair, the parent, was very big in his sons, David and Reed, in their amateur wrestling career. And David did show us last night, living legend, a lot of amateur skills.
Well, amateur skills are great if you're wrestling in an amateur tournament where a takedown's a takedown and an escape's an escape. This is different. This is thumb in the eye and broken bones, and this makes amateur wrestlers cry.
Yeah, especially when the opponent is Eazy-E himself, Eric Bischoff. I don't think you're going to see many amateur wrestling moves from Eric Bischoff. David Flair needs to be well aware of the fact that Eric Bischoff will stoop to any low in this match. Be prepared.
Bischoff doesn't care about accumulating points or riding time. He wants control of the company, period.
Now, the point about David Flair brought up across, we'll let you know, and we all realize this here, because we've known David for many, many years, being with his father and a friend of his father's, and David has an athletic background. He's not just some kid off the street who's never participated in athletics before. He's been an amateur wrestler, and so maybe sometimes...
Let's just keep our fingers crossed.
Well, that's what I'm trying to... I don't know, I guess I'm trying to, in my own mind, give David a chance here, but it doesn't look good.
Yeah, just remember how things were for the past couple of years, Tony. Compare them to how nice things have been for the past few weeks, and let's hope we don't regress.
I tell you, Bischoff is a mature man. If he wasn't positive he could beat David Flair, this coward wouldn't even be this close to the ring.
Sure. And he was going to get nowhere near the ring had it been Ric Flair. As you see the sellout crowd at the Schottenstein Arena, Schottenstein Center, home of the Buckeyes. And the focus of David Flair.
Well, he's got to focus. Actually, just keep his distance. Let Eric Bischoff throw a kick. Grab his ankle, lock it, fall back, and snap his leg like a twig.
Absolutely. One thing we were very happy to see last night, like we talked about this, was when Hogan and Buff Bagwell did the old schoolboy where they pushed David over to start all of that horrible beating. David did not stand for it. He jumped right up and jumped on Hollywood Hogan. So David Flair has that fire burning in him. He will not back down at all, even when he was outnumbered, surrounded by members of the NWO.
We saw that Flair family fire exhibited earlier this evening, and we also saw it last night at Sold Out when he got right in the face of Hollywood Hogan. Did this youngster, this 19-year-old David Flair, with so much pressure on his shoulders in this match.
Would you think it's ironic that Randy Pee Wee Anderson would be the referee here? Here's a man fired by Eric Bischoff.
I don't think it's ironic, but I think it's good.
I think it's great. In the face of what Scott Dickinson has done and all the bad things that have happened to WCW, it's good that something like this would go down.
Bischoff's making a big stink about checking the kid. The kid doesn't have anything on him. Check Bischoff.
He's stalling for time here.
You know, one of the other things that concerns me is that last night he had his father, Ric Flair, right there alongside in the ring. Also, Arn Anderson was at ringside. This is David Flair flying solo against Bischoff.
All right, here comes your bell, and here we go. Didn't expect to see this one when we went on the air tonight about an hour ago, but here we are. If Bischoff loses, then Eric Bischoff will get his head shaved. If not, Bischoff gets the company back, and Ric Flair gets his hair shaved, and Bischoff right now is just toying with David Flair.
Back heel trip takes down David Flair.
Oh, the kid.
Well, he's not covering up his face. Don't stick your head out there.
Well, that's what he's doing, and that's the inexperience. But
Bischoff's not a wrestler. He's going to come in your face.
Well, you called that one, Larry.
Couple of kicks and punches had no effect, but that standing sidekick put David Flair down, and now Bischoff in the corner, just pounding away on the young man. The top of the head. And just walking all over David Flair.
Yeah, just an effort to once again further embarrass and further humiliate David Flair and the entire Flair family.
David Flair with the right hand to the side of the head.
Cover him.
One, two.
Got him. He knocked him out.
Sucker punches count.
He knocked, he hit him in the side of the head and knocked him smack dab out.
And he's gotten change.
That's because he had something in his hand.
He had a roll of dimes or I can't see it.
A roll of coins in his hand.
Keep Heenan out of there. He'll grab it.
It's over.
Here comes the Prez.
That's a one-punch knockout.
David Flair. Look, there they are, quarters. Came prepared.
Yeah, don't shortchange him with dimes.
Absolutely.
He leveled him with a roll of quarters.
I've never seen a roll of dimes in my life.
Oh, there's the son of the dirtiest player in the game.
Well, Flair had a trick up his sleeve, and he passed it on.
Look at that. Mongo is putting the quarters on the eyelids of Bischoff.
Like you're in a suntan booth.
Well, they just buried him is what they did.
You know another good part of this? The Wolfpack, the big guys in the NWO, they're still out of here. They're still in their limousine somewhere, chased away by the Horsemen earlier.
And did you see what Flair has in his hands?
No.
Clippers.
Good.
Oh, hey, look at this. Look where they're... If I can borrow a term from Eric Bischoff, let me call this one.
His hair's turning white.
Oh, I'm good at this. That's for you, Eric.
Bischoff's aging 20 years before my very eyes.
Oh. Ooh, is he ever. Oh, he's... Actually, when he comes... That was a horrible haircut anyway, so this may do him some good. Eric Bischoff, this is not... been your run.
Hey, he's been asking for it for years, the jerk.
Now let's do it again. Ready?
Oh, Flair's just loving this, isn't he?
Just leave it like that.
Well, now that Bischoff's clean cut, we can give him a job in the cafeteria. Would you like French fries with these?
I would want his hands on my food. Head of Eric Bischoff. And another good point to bring up right here as they'll go from behind. Oh, he looks like a skunk now.
Flair with a skunk man.
He does. Ooh. He does. Look at that white stripe.
Most important part, yeah, the haircut's great, but Ric Flair remains in control.
Yes. When someone wakes him up, let him know I've got a good barber in Charlotte, North Carolina for him.
He shaved any closer. He looked like Hogan.
Oh, he's starting to come to.
Somebody get him a mirror.
Oh, no. This looks... Let's see. Look at that. It's like Pepe Le Pew.
Finish off Le Pew. There we go.
Oh, the roll of quarters.
Keep the change.
Quick. Someone get him a hat. He's an ugly man. Oh, this is quite a moment. Quite a moment in the history of Nitro. You won it, Eric.
You did this to me.
You did this to yourself. David Flair, one punch, loaded hand, roll of quarters. As Bischoff is blaming Randy Anderson, Bischoff went down and went out.